that. It's one of the deadliest pathogens the world has faced in the last 100 years. Trying to crack the coronavirus code is now the top priority at Fort Detrick, Maryland, in the Homeland Security Biodefense Center. Behind these doors, one of the most secure labs in the country. Researchers in full biohazard suits now working to understand how the coronavirus spreads and infects so easily. I asked senior research scientist Paul Dabish about the pressure knowing so many people have already died.
It's very great. Like, we are working around the clock because of that, to try to answer questions that we're being asked about this virus. And hopefully those results can help to inform our response to this. And we know the clock is ticking on this.
Among the most urgent questions, how long does the virus hang in the air and remain infectious? In this aerosol chamber, researchers recreate the sunlight, heat, and humidity levels for any climate in the country, from New York in springtime to Arizona's deserts to Florida's beaches. If the virus can remain airborne, it could potentially spread more easily through hospitals, prisons, meatpacking operations, schools, and nursing homes.
We're most concerned about the really small droplets that you can't see, because those are the ones that get down deep into your lung. And for most infectious agents, that's when you get the worst possible infection.
Those could be deadly.
Droplets smaller than a human hair. Researchers already know the virus can survive on cardboard for 24 hours, plastic and steel for 3 days, glass for 4 days. Last month, this lab announced that common household disinfectants can quickly kill the virus. But another critical discovery received less attention. The pathogen does not survive well in direct sunlight and at certain humidity levels.
What we have found so far is that sunlight seems to be very detrimental to the virus. And so within minutes, the majority of the virus is inactivated on surfaces and in the air in direct sunlight.
That could mean the virus would die quickly on anything left outside, from playground equipment to backyard furniture to shopping carts. It's not clear whether sunlight kills the virus on skin.
Our preliminary results say yes, that the sunlight on plastic will inactivate the virus very quickly.
Potential good news for anyone anxious to get outside.
Researchers say the fact that this virus dies quickly in direct sunlight but can live for days on surfaces inside could directly affect how Americans live and play this summer.